and welcome to an episode of Meet the Makers here on Block News. My name is Rebecca Hope, and today we are being joined by Erwin Wering from Amsterdam, from the company Atrace, the CEO and founder. Welcome, Erwin.
Thank you for having us, and I'm very impressed by how you just pronounced my name.
I'm South African, so I should be able to pronounce the Dutch names as we speak
Afrikaans
in South Africa, so it's very similar. So it's great to have you on the show and to be talking about affiliate marketing and what you guys are doing. Now, you're a little bit different to, like you said, the 98% of other blockchain companies that are using Ethereum. You are creating your own blockchain. Tell us a little bit about that.
Yes, so we are Trace. So we are the first fully decentralized affiliate marketing platform. So we are an entirely custom-made blockchain. So we fully developed from scratch. And we are capable of registering and auditing any advertisement click on chain, whether that's a sale or not a sale. And once implemented, it means you can solve the main problems with affiliate marketing, which are the trust tracking and transparency issues and the rather hefty fees, which we can bring down with more than 95%. And I should probably first explain what affiliate marketing is, because I'm not sure if everybody knows that.
Let's run over that. What is affiliate marketing?
So basically, if you look at the world of online marketing, there are three different types of sports, roughly speaking. So online marketing is currently worth about $230 billion. And you can roughly divide it in three different sports. So if you have a website, you can make money by putting an advertisement on your website and get paid per view, which is basically a display advertisement. You just get paid because people have seen it. You can also get paid by click, which is what Google is doing. So if someone clicks on the banner, which is placed in your advertisement. Or you can get paid by actual sale achieved. So this is when you have a blog or website, someone goes to the banner of, let's say, an insurance company, clicks on it. Once the visitor is at the insurance company website, closes a sale, and then the insurance company is paying a commission to the website advertising this insurance. This is pay per sale achieved. This is affiliate marketing. This is a logical endpoint of online marketing, and that is what we are targeting, and that's currently worth about $13 billion a year.
Mm-hmm. And of that, those $13 billion, a lot of 25% of that is going to a middleman, and you want to step in there and erase that.
That is the actual 25%. So yes. So that is what we are targeting. So the problem is that it's a very healthy way of online marketing, right? You get paid per sale achieved. But the problem is there's a middleman involved, which is called the affiliate network, which is tracking and tracing every individual click generated by the website. And it's also arranging the payments from, let's say, the insurance company to the website in case a sale has been closed. Now, because of the middleman, everything is a bit of a mystery. So there's massive trust tracking and transparency issues. Mm-hmm. And on top of that, they take fees, which are currently worth $13 billion a year. So what we want to do is we want to apply blockchain to the core of this marketing concept. So we lock the agreement between the website and, let's say, the insurance company or the Amazon or whatever you want to promote. Mm-hmm. And by tracking and tracing every individual click on chain, you make the middleman obsolete. So the fees go out of the window. Mm-hmm. This is one. So that's a game changer in itself. But more importantly, the trust tracking and transparency issues are solved. And this is this is a massive issue, which we will then solve.
Now, you've developed a couple of startups, internet startups, and you've been in commercial banking for many years in London and all over the place. So why did you decide to start Atrace? Why now?
Well, I've had experience with affiliate marketing about 14 years ago. I had a lot of websites which were trying to sell games. And what happened is you would sell 10,000 leads and then the middleman would tell you, hey, sorry, man, you only got one sale. So, and I didn't believe the middleman, but there's nothing I could do. So it was really demotivating. And because of that, which is one of the reasons why I went back to commercial banking. Now, I had another startup, which I had to move from London because I lived 14 years in London back to the Netherlands because of the Brexit. And when I was in the Netherlands, when Ethereum got released, it started to dawn on me that, you know, blockchain, you can not only use for a cryptocurrency, but the underlying tech you could actually use to solve user cases. And this was the first user case that came to mind. It's the no-brain. It's the perfect fit for a blockchain. It's a perfect use case for blockchain. Because my problem is with a lot of ICOs, and do stop me if I get overboard, but I think 95% of the ICOs doesn't make any sense. There's no use case. And with use case, I mean you're solving a problem. You're not just adding value. And if you have a use case, most of them you can solve without blockchain. And then if they have a use case which you can only solve by blockchain, then most of them don't even have a tech team, let alone they can guarantee any economical traction in the near future. So all of that has been covered by a trace. But this is how basically I got involved into blockchain. It was because of my bad experience with affiliate marketing. And so I've been.
And you kept it in mind and you realized that it is actually a perfect fit. If we look at what is existing out there compared to what a trace is offering. So basically it would be very similar the way that you log in and you select, you know, who you want to partner with your marketing strategies. And then how is it different though, you know, on the back end? You see it obviously with the blockchain technology being integrated and there being this transparent system. So how will that look differently visually to the user?
It will not look in any way different to the end user. So the publishers and the merchants, the websites and the people who are trying to sell something, they nowadays use a user interface from the middleman, the affiliate network, where they can basically select who to work with. You can look at their earnings or they can look at how many leads have been tracked, etc. It will be exactly the same when they are using your trace user interface. There will be no difference for them. Apart from the fact that for the first time, they know for sure they're not being screwed over, mind my language. And, you know, for the merchant side, for example, the insurance companies, let's say that nowadays they pay $10 million a year in commissions, this can go down to $7.5 million a year. Yeah. So it's been absolute game changer. So for end users, there's, and also because we made sure that, you know, the actual commission payment still itself is still in fiat. There will be no reason for them to not jump ship and use your trace ecosystem via network.
So let's talk about how you are planning on entering the market and how you are planning on allocating your ICO funds.
So entering the market. So, well, first of all, we've made sure, like I just touched on that, in terms of user experience, there will be no difference, body advantages. So half of our founders together own about 1% of the Dutch affiliate market. So what we've really thought this through. So what you can expect is that we'll be live. I mean, the underlying blockchain, we have our own blockchain, has already been developed. We are now currently finalizing user interfaces for the end users. What you can expect is three news items from a trace this year. First one being a trace has accomplished the first automatic sale on-chain via an affiliate network system, the affiliate ecosystem from a trace. That'll be a world first. The second one will be a trace will allocate about 1% of the Dutch affiliate market on chain. And then the third one is going to be a trace is going to kill all the fees. And by that point, I guarantee you the news will reach globally. Because that's a game changer. Because you talk about $13 billion a year.
Is there a region that's or regions where you see it starting from and then expanding to?
Yeah, dependent on the result of the ICO. So we guarantee it's going to be live this year because we already have raised enough via the private round to go live. So the more we bring in via the ICO, the more quickly we can expand to other countries. The first other countries we are targeting are obviously Germany, UK, Scandinavia, and then we'll go to the US.
Okay.
And the Pacific. Mm-hmm. It's also worth mentioning that I might go way ahead of myself in terms of information overload. But one of the other advantages of tracking and tracing every individual click on chain via affiliate marketing is that, and there's a couple of other ones. So like I just touched on, you solve the trust tracking transparency issue, you take out the fees, there's no more slow complicated payments, but there's also you take away the entry barriers of the merchants. So nowadays if I want to sell, I don't know, goldfish and I make one sale a month, there's no middleman that will accept me as an advertiser on the affiliate marketing. So I have to go to Google. We take away those entry barriers. So once the system is properly embedded globally, it will make affiliate marketing a larger part of online marketing as a whole. So we can arguably become way more of a competitor with, for example, Google. There's a real alternative now. You don't pay per click. You know, you never know what the end result is. You only pay per sale achieved. So we're also going to touch on emerging markets and long tail by Q2 next year.
Wow. So yeah, thanks for sharing that. That's interesting. So that's really, that is really changing the market. That is really revolutionizing things. So you're giving the smaller guys an opportunity to grow as well without all those restrictions, which is really great. Yes. Okay, let's talk about your team for a little bit. Who's all on the team and what advisors have you been having?
So we have 7 founders. Half of them have a background in commercial banking, London and New York. The other half are the IT guys, and some of them have built very impressive companies with rather hefty exits. And then we have another third that has extensive experience with affiliate marketing, which is, of course, the user case for targeting. So the founder team almost covered every aspect of our company already. Now, the advisors, we've chosen them carefully. So we've chosen them in such a way that we can guarantee deliver, let's say, the best intel service support of every aspect of the Trace ecosystem. So, for example, we have a thought leader in corporate governance on a global level, which is a professor in Hong Kong. He will touch on the delegated proof of stake principle that we've implemented for the blockchain. We have an ethical hacker, which main job is to try to hack banks. Mm-hmm. So we are certain that the security side of the trades is fully covered. We have a senior director of eBay that will help us with emerging markets and long tail. We have 2 very strong lawyers and, of course, a whole law team behind it to assure that legally we've covered every aspect in terms of compliance, in terms of how we are allowed to use our data based on Dutch and European law, etc. And then, of course, we have some very strong programmers, last but definitely not least. And we have the Crypto Crowd, which is a globally known influencer who decided to become an advisor after he interviewed us.
Okay, great. So you have a robust team, and then you said that you're not registered offshore. Instead, you are registered in the Netherlands. Why is that? Why has that been important? Yeah. That's quite different.
Yeah, it's absolutely different. And yes, I have to admit, it's definitely hurting us tax-wise. It's hurting us big time. However, we look beyond the ICO. We actually want to build an ecosystem here. So, and because of that, it's way smarter to be registered in the Netherlands. Of course, it's also way more secure for investors, but it's also way more secure for the merchants. So what we want to do is we want to convince the retail banks and insurance companies, hey, you can do your advertising via us. Mm-hmm. Now, I have a lot of experience with trying to bring on banks and insurance company on board with my previous startup. And the only way to accomplish this is by being registered in a secure, legit country like the Netherlands. If we would be registered in Panama or even Malta, which is still in Europe, I can guarantee you most of the retail banks will not buy it. They will not get engaged with your proposition, regardless of how good you are. So this is a very thought through decision. Mm-hmm. Keeping into account we really want to grow quickly. Mm-hmm. And the purchaser side is not a problem. They are calling us already on a daily basis. So the main chance is going to be to convince the big banks, the big insurance companies, and perhaps the Amazons of this of this world to start working with us. Mm-hmm. It's not going to fly if you're based in the Bahamas. Hence why.
Okay. Yeah. And tell me about, so what is your monetizing structure here?
In terms of how
do you monetize?
Yes. So of course, there's a Trace token. So the purchaser needs a tray every time a click is registered on chain, but it's very little. So roughly speaking, it's like you need about $1 for every 1,000 leads to be registered on chain, which is economically a no-brainer because it basically means, for example, in insurance, if you send out 1,000 leads on average with a conversion of 1%, you make about $1,200. Spending $1 to assure that $1,200 is rightfully allocated to you and nobody's screwing you over is a no-brainer. So purchasers need a trace to register clicks on chain. But all of that a trace will go to the notes, to the miners. We don't see that. Now, the merchants, the insurance company, every time they pay a commission to the website, they need a very small percentage of that goes to a trace, 0.5%. Mm-hmm. It used to be 25%. In our world, it's 0.5%. the 0.5%, for example, they spent, they give $100 to a website because I sold an insurance. $50 will go to a trace. A trace will be bought of that, of which 80% will be burned to increase the value of a trace, and 20% will go to the trace network to maintain the ecosystem.
Wow.
So that's how to monetize it.
Okay. So you guys have really thought about all aspects of this, and it sounds like you've got a really in-depth understanding of where you need to be in the market and how you're going to improve things. So yeah, all the best with the project, with the trace, and the next step. So what is the short-term and long-term goal?
Short-term goal will be, as I just touched on, half of November, end of November, you will see a news item saying first insurance, because we can target retail insurance first as a product. First insurance, fully automated, sold online via blockchain. That will be the first target. Then we will scoop in a significant part of the Dutch affiliate market. That will be the short-term target, end of this year. So we promise real economical traction this year. And then the long-term target will be roll out to other countries. And at a later stage, the trade transparency protocol, which means that the framework we've built, because our blockchain can process between 6,000 to 60,000 clicks a second on chain, which brings us to a whole new level compared to, for example, Ethereum.
Yeah.
So there are industries which have approached us for other user cases as well. So perhaps we roll out to other user cases which need similar capacities, but I cannot disclose that quite yet.
Okay.
But it's looking rather positive.
But long term, yes. You're hoping to see what in the grander scheme?
Grander scheme long term will be we will have rolled out to multiple countries. We will have entered countries which has never seen affiliate marketing before. That'll be the long term project. And the ecosystem of the blockchain itself might be used for other financial services related user cases.
I think you will achieve that goal. It sounds like you have everyone on board, the right people. Thank you so much for sharing with us more about Atrace. What is the website that we can go to and get involved in?
It's atrace.com.
Atrace, on his shirt there, atrace.com. Nice and simple. Thank you so much for talking with us today, Arvin.
Yeah, thank you for having us. Thank you for taking the time.
We're talking to Arvin Vering, the CEO of Atrace from Amsterdam in the Netherlands. My name is Rebecca Hope from Block News, and this is an episode of Meet the Makers.